set to kick off here, and it's not a hold game for either of these teams. It's time for the coin toss now, presented by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Florida Atlantic is kicking off first, and we're ready to get this game underway. From his own goal line, he's to the 20. He makes it to the 25-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. They make the stop at the 20-yard line.
Ouch. Pretty big loss on the play, and I think they might want to reassess the strategy here. Perhaps run a screen. Maybe hit the tight end on a short pattern. This D-line is just a bit much to handle at this moment.
Second and 15. Ball on the 20. Quick throw. He's out to the 30. And he's tackled at the 39-yard line. Good pick. And catch there on second down.
Yep, it was good enough to get him a first down. That's just a nice play.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on their own 39. Pulls this one out to the left, and he dropped it.
Number six, the intended run play. That makes it second and 10.
Larry. Watch the team.
Here's the throw. I don't think he got anything on that.
That'll bring up third and 8.
From their own 41-yard line, third down. Makes the grab and steps out right away.
What a relief it is for a quarterback to know that he's got a receiver like this who can step up when he needs him on third down.
First and 10, ball on the 43. Made right around the 34. Great job by the running back, and that's a gain of 9.
That'll make it second and inches.
He's taken down at the 36. And this is the 8th play of the drive. It's the tailback. And he makes it out to about the 34-yard line.
That was nose-to-nose football right there. And the defense this time wins the battle.
So it's 4th down, and the offense is still on the field. They're all tied in on the line here on 4th and short. Nice run there.
This is the kind of steady, strong drive that coaches love to see. Right now, they're firing on all cylinders.
Here's play number 10 on the drive. And he's taken down at about the 19-yard line. It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. Inside the 10. He's knocked out of bounds at the 7-yard line.
He gets another set of downs and, more importantly, opens up a whole host of play calling possibilities for the coaching staff.
Here's the 12th play of the drive.
rid of this one.
They're at the 7. It's second down. Tackled for a loss. Here's play number 14 of this drive. Short pass, middle of the field. Brought down around the 2-yard line. Fourth down, they'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. Central Florida could take the lead with this field goal.
Kicks away.
And it's through the uprights.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. It's fielded at the 2. He's to the 20. And he's taken down at the 30. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. Fires out to his receiver. Knocked out of bounds at the 41-yard line. And a nice pickup there.
I'll tell you what, the defense gambled a bit here and came with the blitz, and a quarterback showed tremendous poise by making a good read and delivered a nice ball to the open man.
Zips it to the tight end. He's at midfield. And he tackles him hard at the 43-yard line.
First down.
Sacked.
You know, Brad, that time the defense brought the blitz, and I think it confused the offensive line. It's one thing to pick up the blitz, but you also have to be accountable for the defensive lineman, and that time the lineman got to the quarterback and came up with a sack.
Defense looking for another sack here on this 2nd and 13 situation. 5 guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. He's going to try and scramble. He's tackled at the 46. They've got all their DBs in there to match up against the 5-wide set. He's wrapped up for the sack.
A defensive end with this kind of speed is an offensive's worst nightmare. He's got the ability to collapse the pocket on any given pass play. And as a play caller, you constantly have to be aware of it. Whether you're going to roll away from him or you're going to chip with a tight end or a running back, you're constantly concerned and aware of a big, strong defensive end.
The sack makes this a 4th and very long. And he can't hang on to the ball.
I know I'd be nervous with 11 guys sprinting down the field at me, but the first job of a return man is to catch the ball.
And I'll tell you, in a close game like this, you just can't do stuff like that. Well, the guys are chomping at the bit down there, waiting for the game to start back up. Central Florida is up by 3. He fights forward to about the 26. From their own 26-yard line. Second down. After 1, this game's still pretty close. 3-0. Knights. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the 2nd quarter. Tackle around the 31-yard line. It's 3rd down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. Makes the catch, and he's got nowhere to go. They've They've got 10 guys up. It looks like they're going to try to block this one. He's taken down at the 42. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. And he's level at the 44-yard line. That makes it first and 10. From the 44-yard line, it's first down. Caught out in the open. And down he goes at the 31-yard line. He's at the 20. They'll bring him down at the 17-yard line. And he's tackled after positive yardage.
That's good for a
And a quick throw. And he is drilled at the 10-yard line.
Number 26 makes the tackle at the 10-yard line. That makes it 3rd and 3.
They get nice yardage on that run.
That makes it first and goal.
Pressure coming. And they make the stop at the 5-yard line.
Gain of 1 on the play. That brings him.
This is the 8th play of this drive. He's gobbled up in the backfield. Pretty good defense there on the option. They'll stop him for a loss of 1. Big 3rd and goal. Can the defense stop him? Slings it. And he's tackled right around the 2-yard line. Converts the extra point. A 10-play, 59-yard drive. And the result, 7 points.
You know, Brad, a lot of times you have to watch practice and watch a 7-on-7 drill to not see the ball touch the ground. This time, they went the entire length of the field. The ball never touched the ground. Great execution by the quarterback and receiver.
Taken at the 5. And he's tackled at the 28-yard line. With 1 quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. He gets out to about the 28-yard line. From their own 28-yard line, 2nd down. Inside give.
You know, these backwards plays can have a psychological impact. It can damage a team's confidence if it keeps happening.
Airing it out long. Drops it. Excellent series by this defense, forcing them to go 3 and out.
And the offense really struggled on this drive. They're going to have to pick it up if they want to move the ball on these guys.
He They'll bring him down at the 47.
You know, we're getting so used to pinball football with a lot of points. Kind of fun to see defenses play this way.
Kind of refreshing, isn't it? I mean, every single week we call games and you're seeing scores in the 30s and 40s. This is one of those low-scoring games. Which offense will get that big break eventually could be the team that wins it.
The offense now will take the field, and they hope to have the same success they had on their last drive.
This offensive coordinator's got to be feeling so good about the execution that he's seeing from his quarterback and his wide receiver. Because, again, they put so much time in trying to put a plan together. And to be able to see that actually come into play makes you feel pretty good as a play caller.
First and 10.
From the 37-yard line, first down. Florida Atlantic is up by four. Great concentration to haul it in. That's a great tackle at the 19. The Owls call a timeout. That's their second of the half. He gets out to about the 18-yard line. The 10. Big play there, and now they're looking at first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
Touchdown, Florida Atlantic. And he hits the PAT. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Fielded at the four. Tackle at the 27. Their last drive ended in a punt, so this quarterback's going to be looking for something better on this drive. Complete across the middle. Tackle made at the 40.
There you go. Good read by the quarterback to give the offense a new set of downs. If the defense wants to line up in man, work that slant route until they stop it.
And he's tackled right away.
He made a really good move at the line of scrimmage. Sometimes all you need to do is throw off the defender's timing just a little bit at the start of the play.
Here they come, and he's going to be sacked for a loss.
The defenders played the snap count perfectly. He found the path into the backfield and didn't let the quarterback get away.
He's taken down at the 26.
I credit the quarterback on that pass. He made a great read and delivered a very nice pass for the first down.
Pressure got to him, and he put it on the ground. The offense falls on it.
Kill, kill, kill. Number three. Slap, slap, slap. And two.
The cavalry's coming. And he hits him hard at the 41. Pretty impressive pass rush right there.
These hits take a toll on a quarterback, physically and psychologically. The blockers have got to do a better job of taking care of him.
Going deep. No, incomplete. So at the end of the half, FAU in front, 14-3.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. Both of these defenses are opportunistic. They're very good at forcing turnovers. But both quarterbacks, David, have done a very good job while trying to maintain an aggressive mindset, a They haven't forced the ball. The runners have done a good job keeping it put away.
Yeah, and as much as you preach that all throughout the week, it's still hard to do. It's hard to execute. And being able to see what you see on the defensive side of the football and adjust to it offensively, how about protecting the quarterback so he's not getting hit from the blind side, fumbling the football, ball carriers running with the football, keeping it tight to their body, not giving it away. So, you know, between running backs, receivers, and quarterbacks, offensive linemen blocking, did a great job executing on the offensive side of the football, not to give away any turnovers.
Just about set to start the second half. What are you looking for?
I'm looking to see which team has that decided schematical advantage.
And if they can find it, they'll blow holes three or four axe handles wide. Brad and Kirk will be there to call the second half.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin.
Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20. Gets out to about the 21. They're 2 for 2 in finding the end zone on their last two drives. Let's see how they do here. And now he's got room to run. Makes it out to about the 29. Quick throw out to the receiver, and they'll get him in the backfield. Loss of 2.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Makes it out to about the 36. They'll drop it for a loss.
Think about the speed and instincts it takes for a linebacker to get from his position into the backfield to make a play like that. That's well done.
Makes it to the 47.
That makes it first and 10.
He tackles him for a loss. From their own 42-yard line, second down. Finds his man, and they take him down immediately. And he's going to come up with a sack. Fourth and long here after the sack. And down he goes at the 31. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Second down, 8 yards to go. Ball on the 33. And he's taken down right around the 34.
Call it a gain of 1 yard. That makes it makes it third and seven.
Throws it out there. Complete. And he's finally shoved out at the 30-yard line. Now it's first and 10 after the big pass play. A handoff, tackled for a loss. Throws quick to the receiver and it falls incomplete.
You know, Brad, this is one of those plays where the quarterback just wants to apologize to the wide receiver, maybe every other member of this offense. But the wide receiver, if he's smart, will come up to that quarterback, tell him to forget about it. Let's move on to the next play.
Easy.
Flair. He's looking for six. Incomplete. Almost picked off.
Number two was the intended receiver on the play. That'll bring up fourth and 13.
He's going to aim this one to the sideline, try to kick it out of bounds. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. They were forced to punt the ball away the last time they had it. They'll be looking for a little more out of their offense on this possession. Play action. And he's knocked down immediately after the catch. He zips it. He's hit and taken down.
That makes it first and 10.
Over the middle, got his tight end, and he's hit before he can go anywhere. Around the 22-yard line.
That makes it second and 2.
Go, kill, kill.
Hand off, and he's met in the backfield. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. Some open field. What a play, and that is first and goal.
That's a deep 19. That makes it first and goal.
Touchdown, Owls. Splits the uprights with the extra point. So that's a 7-play, 80-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
He'll return it from the 6. And he's taken down at the 47-yard line. The Owls continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
The offense takes the field again. They were forced to punt their last time out.
Down 2 possessions. This offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
Gets to about the 47-yard line.
No gain on the play. That brings up second and 9.
Second down and 9 to go. Ball in their own 47. He's tackled at the 45-yard line. That's three down and one to go. The Owls with an 18-point cushion. Just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. Nice run up the middle. It's first and 10. Ball on the 41-yard line.
That was a great route by the receiver. It started out looking like a streak, but in reality, it was going to be a corner route the whole time. Nice job of beating the zone coverage and getting the first down.
Got a man. Watch out here. And he's tackled at the 20-yard line. So it's second down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the first down. The stop around the 8-yard line.
Check, check. And
takes it up the middle for a nice run. That brings him second. This is the 8th play of this drive.
Short distance. He had great blocking up front on that play.
Well, they're going to try for the 2-point conversion. They're crowding the line. Hands off left, and they got him behind the line. It was an 8-play, 54-yard drive, but they just get 6 points after failing to convert for two. He's taken down at the 41-yard line. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Up the middle for a nice gain. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Just under 3 to go in regulation. They'll bring him down around the 31-yard line.
Gain 3 yards. First down.
Central Florida just took their first time out.
If you can consistently run effectively like this, it'll force the defense to pay more attention to the run, and that creates chances in the play-action passing game.
Caught out of the open. And down he goes at the 5-yard line.
How about the big fellas up front? This line will have to continue to play like that to build the consistency to help this offense be effective.
Watch out for a pass play when you're in a goal line D. Slings it out and it gets tipped.
It's an intelligent play. All you
you have to do sometimes is get your hand on the ball.
From the 5-yard line, second down. Touchdown, Florida Atlantic. And he converts the extra point. Florida Atlantic ready to kick this one off. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 26-yard line.
Boy, the two offensive coordinators have to be loving this. In fact, you can look over at our booth next to us and see how much they're enjoying it with a big smile on their face. The defensive coordinators, on the other hand, might be looking for a pink slip on Monday.
We're about set to start things up again. Just under 2 to go in the game. Going long. Incomplete. He tried to hit his receiver in stride, but overthrew it a little too much.
That'll come in time. Just repetition, throwing that same pass over and over, and he'll be fine.
Here we go, here we go.
Second and 10. Ball on the 26-yard line. Throws it deep. A junior makes the catch. Tackle made at about the 29-yard line. Taken down at the 11-yard line.
I tell you what, this defense better start to get pressure on the quarterback. They're giving him way too much time back there to throw the football.
Kill!
Gunner 3!
Fires quickly, and he's got his man. He is drilled at the 7.
That makes it 2nd and 6.
From the 7-yard line, it's 2nd down.
Short throw for the quarterback, but not easy. He made that play work.
He makes the PAT. Tackled at the 43-yard line.
Well, I'm sure Reese is having fun giving updates from this game to our other games going on today. We've had back-to-back-to-back-to-back scores.
Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. A little over a minute in the game. He gets to about the 31-yard line.
It's great when a running attack comes through for the first down like this. It makes an offense so much more versatile.
And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. The quarterback takes a knee, and that's always a good sign if you're a fan of this team. From the 33-yard line, 2nd down. He's at the 20. Makes it to the 17. That's going to do it for this one. Our final score, 28-16.
FAU.
And the UCF Knights.
Thanks for joining us for another game of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk and everyone here at EA Sports, Brad Nussler saying, and we'll see you next time.